All right, so welcome to another installment of our Masterclass series. My name is Zach O'Farrell. I'm the Director of Education Programs at the Afro-Latin Jazz Alliance. And I'm very excited to welcome back my friend, the wonderful percussionist Everton Isidoro, who's going to be talking to us today about music from his home state in Brazil of Bahia. And yeah, that's about all I want to say right now. I want to hear what Everton has to say. I just want to give everyone, I just want to remind everyone to turn off your microphones unless you're asking a question, so we don't get unwanted extra noise in the feed. So yeah, thanks a lot for being here. And Everton, you got it. How you doing, man?
I'm doing great, man. First of all, I really want to like say thank you. You, thank you for Latin Jazz for having me one more time. And now to talk about the, like I say, my favorite beats from Bahia, because I feel so blessed because I grew up and I learned in a place that is so musical and we have like so many rhythms, you know? And I kind of pick some of these rhythms based like historically as well to like, I'm thinking about tell a story because it's important know where everything came from, you know, and how my music and how the Bahia music it is the way it is right now. So it was a process throughout like so many years. And to start in Brazil, we have this, it's no argument, but this kind of conversation where the samba born, where everything started. Some people say that everything started in Rio de Janeiro. Some people say everything started in Bahia. In my opinion, everything started in Bahia. Of course, because I came from Bahia. But for sure, this rhythm, the samba, comes from... There's another thing. Some people say the samba came from samba. There's a rhythm from Angola. And some people say that samba comes from the samba de samba cabila. That is one of the rhythms that we have inside of our religion, the candomblé. So if you say, if you think about, you think like rhythmically, you're gonna see that it's way more closer of the samba cabila than the samba from Angola. So I want to start playing the samba cabila for you guys. And after, we're gonna see how samba it is, not just one rhythm. And I'm gonna say to you, because some people think like samba is only one thing, but samba it is so many things actually. Let's start with the samba cabila. The main thing, it is the clave, the glues like that. Sometimes people get confused and play this clave because they start with two notes in the offbeat. So, one. So, now I have a sample of this clave and I will show you guys the atabax rhythm body. So the last class I explained that, but I explain one more time. In the candomblé, we have three atabax, there's three instruments like with like drums. We have three drums and we have agogô, that is a bell. And that's the formation that we have inside of the candomblé. So I don't have three atabax. Atabax is this instrument. But we have this one in three different sizes. So the biggest one, rum, the medium, rum P, and the smaller, lé. So I'm playing congas just to represent because I don't have yet three atabax. So samba cabila clave. Thank you. just see one thing. Samba, we have the tundum, 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 tundum. That, like, if you think about like four notes, like you're gonna see the notes always going the four and the one. So it's gonna one, one, four, one, four, one, four, one, four, one, four, one. That's part of the cadence of the samba. And you put the slap in between. So similar of the clave, so sometimes you get confused, but like, it's important if you keep like a note is different because it goes like that. Between the orisha and the music, so the guy that plays the rune is the responsible, because sometimes, like I said, people think the person that plays the rune is like improvising, but actually it is a conversation between the orisha and the musician. Tudo, like, everything goes around the dance and what the orisha wants to bring in this moment. So I put it together, the rune and the rumpi, and I'm gonna try to show you guys how I play this rhythm part. Thank you. right now because, like Zach said, he wanted me to say my favorite beats from Brazil, from Bahia. And because last week you guys watched the Rumpeless Orchestra, Leitieres, Leite and Rumpeless Orchestra concert, I wanna show you guys the beat of one of the songs that this orchestra play. And in my opinion, after the Ijexá, I think Ijexá and Agueré are the rhythms that more like play outside of the ceremonies in Bahia. So I'm gonna share with you guys a video of the orchestra playing. This song, and after I'm gonna play the main rhythm, that is the Agueré. Second note is kind of, it's one note that is close, but it's not flam. tree, I receive like a loop, the clave in the atabaque, and I'm gonna try to do the conversation that the room does during the agere. Let's see. Because I think it's important, even though if you guys have any questions about the samba, or can you guys hear me well? So if you guys have any questions about the samba cabila or about the agueré, can you mute yourself, please?
Can you hear me? Hello?
No, I can hear you.
Where's a good place to go to listen to Kabilé?
You say in Brazil?
No, is there like a good website or CD or somewhere to learn more? Or a person or a composer?
You're gonna find so many videos on the YouTube with people playing. And you have song, there is another song. Now I forgot the name. There is bass in samba cabila. But if you put the YouTube, you're gonna see a lot of videos of people. You're gonna find out more people playing, you know? People that are like musicians playing. The songs just with samba cabila. Maybe you can find. But for sure, the best thing to do is go to Salvador and watch over there, because I think the energy, and you can understand how things work, because you're gonna see the rhythm. You're gonna listen to the rhythm, you're gonna see the dance, and I think when you visualize that, you understand the connection between the dance and the music. And I think that's the most important thing, you know, that's the main thing in this music that we play over there.
One more question. Are the time signatures different than, because samba is like 2-4 typically. Will Kabylie also be 2-4 or different?
No, this one is for sure it is not 2-4 because it. This one is 4. At least the clave, for sure is 4. So the delay we play. CD rompida goes 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4. You understand? Any more questions?
Thank you.
Welcome. Other questions? Good. So now I want to talk about, I want to come back to the samba universe, and I'm going to talk about all another kind of samba that is a kind of another comes from these roots of samba cabila. That is the samba de roda that we have in Bahia. That is the samba that the main clave goes like that. You see that it's so similar to the samba cabila. Let's go the car. I'm gonna record and I'm gonna do like a conga. So many things, and But that's the base of the samba de roda. And I really started talking about the samba de roda because I want to go to the samba junino that is so similar to the samba de roda, but we change the instruments that we use when you go to play the samba de junino. Instead of the congas, we have the timbal, that is this instrument, playing. And the rhythm part, let me just fix over.
Everton. I have a question.
Go ahead.
Apart from, I mean, in the samba de roda is also pandeiro, right?
Yeah, we have pandeiros also.
So what's the setup normally? Like, is congas or, I mean, what's the setup for the samba de roda?
Samba de roda is not congas, atabaques. Usually they have atabaques as well. They have clapping. The rhythm part that did the tambourine usually is clapping.
Okay.
And they have the pandeiro. They do this. If you go to places like Cachoeira, some places in Bahia, they have a different way to play.
Okay.
They play with they have a different technique to play the pandeiro, but the rhythm part, the main thing is like that.
Okay. So it's not like congas are not in the setup normally, right? It's like
conga is more like more the way to do it, you know. I say that I did something more like improvised because that's not the
original.
Yeah, original. You know, I'm just trying to adapt.
Yeah, I got you.
I'm better, you know. Yeah, and the place actually that one I get. Because it is the samba junino, because a lot of people know the samba de roda already because of the capoeira, you know, because capoeira is so strong over here, they play a lot of samba de roda. But then they don't know, like, samba junino, that's so similar of samba de roda, but the main difference is the instrumentation. In samba de roda or in samba junino, we start using the timbal, that is this instrument. In Bahia, they were even playing. I saw a samba junino group playing with triangle, and usually we play just in forró the triangle. But I saw the samba junino, the guy was playing the triangle and tambourine. We have tambourine and we have shakere as well. I see people play shakere as well in samba junino. So. In samba junino, because I'm in my house, this instrument kind of loud, I cannot play like full to get like the real sound. But the basic thing, it is like that. Sometimes variation like, but the main thing is but we put also we call the ghost notes, you know, we put in between this rhythm part, because if you just think the like the rhythm part is straight, it is like that. Make full, play the Gusner side. About the samba duro, everything's fine. Okay, let me see. Right now, we're going to on the most. I want to talk a little bit because I think 2 or 3 days ago, one friend of mine, he asked me about the bossa nova clave, and I was trying to explain him that doesn't exist in Brazil, you know? You don't say, let's play, can you play a bossa nova clave, and you're gonna play a bossa nova or anything. And he came up with this rhythm pattern that is pa, 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 pa. Kind of works if you think about the bossa nova, but it's too straight. We never play this way. Even if you're going to play the bossa nova, we always use this finger to play the ghost notes. And in the instrument, we always thinking about the clave, but like being improvised. But like, if I think, if you think it's not the same, they just pa, 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 pa. We have more things in between, go something like that. And I don't even like to say that it's bossa nova because I think there's more samba, you understand? When I play this rhythm, and I think bossa nova is like, of course, is like one of the things inside of samba. And the main thing is the base, the rhythm pattern that they are thinking about when they play the samba, you know? And I think they what make difference, the harmony and the melody, those kind of things that's more like jazz, you know? I think that's the main thing between the difference between the bossa nova and the samba. But when we play samba, we say teleco teco, né? Like even be free, don't have to follow the same thing all the time, you know? Okay. So, there's the only one thing that I want to say because I heard that question more than once about the bossa nova clave. So, just to make clear, if somebody asks me, I will say we don't have bossa nova clave in Brazil. At least musicians, we don't communicate saying play a bossa nova clave. So far, so good. Any questions? Okay. Question? Go ahead.
I have another one. Yeah. I'm kind of, I'm more focused in the Afro-Cuban stuff, but what I've heard is like the mashishi is kind of the basement of all the rhythms, right? Or kind of the...
All the rhythms from Brazil?
No, I mean, at least from the choro and the samba, right? Like the mashishi is the old one, something like that, right? I don't know if I'm right or not.
Some people say that for sure it is, we can hear the mashishi. inside of the, it's mostly chorinho, samba. Of course, you have that, but like some people say there is a lot of influence of the jongo, you know?
Okay.
Another rhythm that is like so old, you know? And I think our music is the blend, it's blend, all those rhythms blended, you know? But for sure, you can like hear machixe, like jongo and all this stuff, you know?
Okay, okay. Thanks.
Welcome. So, guys, feel free to ask anything. And let me see. And after I'm gonna talk a little bit about the influence, the Latin music, like the Caribbean music in the Bahia culture. And right now, I wanna play one more rhythm. That is the samba partido alto. That is that heavy dismantling. And we improvise as well, but like, if you think about, I think this one is more, this pattern is more like calm, you know, it's more normal. You hear this pattern. Even though when you play the samba partido alto, you don't play that all the time. I, at least when I play, I do. So I kind of play around of this main thing. And I think so many musicians do that. When you go to school like the samba, like with samba schools, they have more like the term rhythm patterns, you know? But if you play partido alto and if you get the pandeiro, if you think the same thing, but you kind of improvise the same, like I did with the agogo before, goes like that. The same thing, the surdo plays a regular rhythm pattern, boom, 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 boom. We call the one and two, boom. The regular rhythm pattern. And let's see. Now, I want to talk with you, let's, like, going back to Bahia. I want to talk about the samba reggae. That is the, and I think it is our main thing, you know, like, let's see, like, we are, like, talking about the rhythm patterns that we have in Brazil. One of the most famous, it is the samba reggae. But I want to start talking about the samba afro because came a little bit before, and Neguinho do Samba, there was one of the musicians that created this amazing music, this amazing music called samba reggae. He came from this group called Iliaie, and they have, I don't have the repique over here today, but it's so similar of this instrument. We have like heads in both sides. This one's repique, Janel. They use more in partido alto. I can play for you guys if you guys want later. I can show you really quick. So the rhythm that I'm going to play in the timbal right now actually is a rhythm that belongs to the repique, but I don't have the repique right now. So the Ilhaê, they kind of have the influence from Rio de Janeiro. In Rio de Janeiro, they play with one stick in one hand, in another hand, they don't use the stick. That's the repique, but in Rio de Janeiro, they call repinique. And I didn't find out why, but it is the same instrument, they just have different names. So in the Ilhaê, the main rhythm part is like that. Thank you. you guys could understand me a little bit. And after, they have the snare drum that plays a rhythm. I say that is the kind of raga, but improvised, you know? Comes this way. If you think about like just the main thing, what they play over there, the snare drum, it is like that. So it goes like that.
Yeah, this is like basic, like similar to the bambula, like New Orleans rhythm, right?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. When you go to samba reggae, you're gonna see more influence of the Caribbean stuff, you know. I don't know.
Yeah.
With samba reggae, is more band. Of course, that's the one of the main thing. So the reggae, the Caribbean rhythms, all the Caribbean rhythms mixed with the rhythms from Bahia, I think that's the samba reggae, you know.
Yeah, what about the bayon? How is the bayon?
The bayon, I can show the bayon. But actually, this one that I just played was samba afro. It's not samba reggae yet.
Okay.
It's a little bit different. But bayon, let me see, because the bayon.
Oh, what's the difference? What can you?
I can. The main thing, it is the instrument that you use, I think.
Okay.
Play bayon. You cannot play without the triangle. You need the triangle that goes. And I like to open, I think I was in four notes, in quarter notes, and I open the two. I said, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. It's like, because if you open the three, in the third note, it's not like, the groove is kind of different. It's too like, I think you hold the swing, you know? So I think I open the note a little bit before the three. So for sure it is the number two, you know, I was thinking about four, and number two was. In Bayão, the main thing is the surdo, but the surdo, no, the zabumba, another instrument they have is the zabumba. I don't have the zabumba over here right now, today. I don't have the zabumba, but it's one thing. I want to play the surdo just because you feel the rhythm part, but something different. It's an instrument that's completely different, for sure, way smaller than this one. Some people play the bayon. The first one closed, and the second one open. And I heard like, heard this way as well, like the opposite, close and open. I prefer. So the last rhythm that I want to talk about is samba reggae. So samba reggae, it is, I think, the main thing that we, one of the main things that we have in Brazil, and became so famous when Paul Simon went to Brazil and recorded this group called Olodum. That is like one of the big representatives of the samba reggae. And they came and played the Central Park, and after that they just like started performing all over the world, and people started like knowing more about this rhythm called samba reggae that was created by Neguinho do Samba. And the thing that he did, because like I said before, ele aí used to have play samba afro with one wood stick and another hand without any stick. He came with the idea to play with two sticks. Like these flexible sticks. At the beginning was vimy, that is one kind of wood stick, but like so flexible. And the style became more like, we can make, we can do more variations with more notes. And I'm gonna show you guys a video clip with Michael Jackson playing Olodum. And I think you guys are going to have a better idea of what I'm talking about. How the thing it is, the way it is. In the name of samba reggae, of course, because it has the reggae influence. And if you guys see, because in this rhythm part, the snare drum goes like that, like the, if you think about the guitar, they're like ching, 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 ching. Have any questions? And they have, we have the surdo, like the surdo one, we call dobra de um, because the guy that plays uses only one. The 24 inches and 22 inches, 24 number one, 22 number two, and those are the melodies of the surdo in the samba reggae. Any questions about samba reggae? You guys have any questions?
No, everything is cool. What more rhythms do you have in Bahia? So,
oh, in Bahia we have so many rhythms.
Yeah, can you tell some names? I wanna write down some names so I can research by myself later.
Okay, so let's see the one that you should like. If you go to Candomblé, I think you should research all of them.
Okay, inside the candomblé, right?
I like the we say rhythms of matriz africana, like
for the orichas, right?
I think you should search all of them. But we had the samba reggae, for sure. There is another one that you should like check it out. Samba de roda. There is a new movement in Bahia called we say pagodão.
Oh, pagoda, yeah. I've heard.
Okay. That is like amazing, especially the evolution the people are doing, the percussionists are doing, the instruments right now. They do like so many crazy stuff. They are so creative, you know? And I think you should check it out as well.
Yeah.
And I think there are some groups that you guys should see, watch, listen, because those groups, that they are the ones that like make our music strong, you know. There is one group right now called with this musician Gabi Guedes. He has this group called Prada Rum. I'm not sure. I think it's Prada Rum, the name of his group. That is really good.
Is it Prada Nu?
Prada Rum.
Prada Rum. Okay.
Yeah.
Prada
Rum. Yeah. Luizinho do Gê is another amazing musician. He has a group now. I'm trying to remember the name of his group. But if you check it out, Luizinho do Gege.
Luizinho.
Do Gege is a percussionist, another percussionist. Now the name, I watched this group so many times, now I can't remember the name of the group. Yeah. So his work is amazing. You're gonna see like little kids from the Terreiros playing like amazing, beautifully. And Rumpilés, another group that is amazing.
Yeah, I know that.
Yeah. And Timbalada for sure, because I think the way that Timbalada make music is more based on the timbal, this instrument. And I think you guys should check it out as well. You know, Timbalada is amazing. Okay. Let me see.
I have a question.
Go ahead.
The batuka is a rhythm inside the richest thing or what? Or not? Batuka or batuque?
Oh, there is a rhythm called batuque. And there
batuque.
There is one thing that people call batucada.
Yeah, that's what that was. I want to ask you this: the difference or the connection between that is different things, right?
Different things. So batucada is more like.
Yeah, the group, right?
Groove,
the batuca.
More like yeah. Carnaval, and you play just like yeah. You say charanga as well, you know.
Yeah,
like, it's more like it's even hard to explain the rhythm patterns that they have because it's not one thing that like a group that they get organized and practicing before like go to carnival parade. Usually they're just friends that get together and start playing, you know.
Yeah,
and I think that's the reason they call batucada because sometimes this name. It's kind of offensive if you see like a percussionist in Bahia.
Okay.
That he's a batuqueiro. He's
okay. Okay.
You know, if you say, yeah. Man, you are batuqueiro, that means like you are a bad percussionist.
Okay, gotcha.
You know, so that's the thing. So batucada doesn't have a good connotation.
Okay.
Okay. Is a rhythm from north, more north. It's still northeast of Brazil.
Okay.
And there's another amazing rhythm as well, but it's different from batucada. You know, batucada thing in batuque is another thing.
Because I've heard the name like batuque, so I was like doing the connection. Like that I was asking myself like, okay, is this connected or not?
Yeah. I have a group. I created a Brazilian symbol, like a samba reggae group here in New York.
Yeah.
Call Mambembe if you guys want to check it out and like join to play with us. It'd be cool.
How is it called? Sorry?
Mambembe.
Mambembe. Like my bembe. Okay.
Yeah. And when I create this group, people start saying that it's a batucada group.
Okay.
And I started to explain, especially to the musician that play with us. Because, oh man, I play this group that is a batucada group. Yo, man, you're not playing a batucada.
Don't say that, right?
We are organized. You're like, you're doing something. Our group is good. But like, just because, you know, left to Brazil, this word, and I think people doesn't like know the exact meaning.
Yeah.
Right around the world, but it's fine. We're okay with that. You know, you don't feel that when you say that. It's all good.
Yeah. Ooh, thank you, man.
Thank you, guys.
Can I ask one more question?
Of course.
You were saying about when we were at the beginning of the talk, I think it was Kabila or something like that, how once you go, it's important to go to Bahia to see the music and how they play it and the groove and how it connects with the dance. Mm-hmm. And how does that, and I think, you know, you see that in other rhythms like samba reggae and whatnot. that's very connected to dance in Brazil. But when people are performing here, like let's say with your band, I forget the name, in New York, what happens with that connection with the dancing when people maybe not that many people know how to dance, or they just dance differently? What happens there?
At least in my group, because I try to bring this background that I have from Brazil and I show the way that we do over there. It's like the same thing that I show you guys in the video clip, the thing like put the sticks in the air, those things like traditional samba reggae music, you know? So I show them how to do this way. But I think if you go, because inside of the religion, I think something completely different. You know, in the religion, you don't go and make a choreography, you know, before the ceremony starts. Like in my group, we kind of try to create a choreography. In this part, we have just the timbal playing. So the musicians that are not playing, you guys are going to put your hands in the air. You're going to step to the right, to the left. You do those kind of things. But inside the ceremonies, we don't have like these kind of things about like rehearsal and choreography, you know? So I think it's more natural. And I think we don't think this way, you know? So with me, in my group, I just show the way that we do in Brazil, you know? And the basic stuff, you know, like put your hands on that side, because I think that's what make another feature that is really good about samba reggae, because back in the day, before that, the musician was just playing. And with samba reggae, musicians became like part of the show. If you go, you're gonna see showmen, people like putting the sticks all the way up, the instruments all the way in the sky, like doing like so many dances, you know? You need to move to play samba reggae, you know? I don't know if I answered your questions either.
Yeah, sure, thank you.
Yeah, guys, I show all the beats that I have in Brazil, and I wish I could, because unfortunately, Brazilian music is a lot about community, you know? And that's how the roots of your music, because we struggle and we were excluded of society after slavery trade and all those kind of things, and our music keep us united. So to play our music, you need more than one musician, you know? I bought a pedal loop, but unfortunately I cannot do everything yet. But one day I hope you'll be able to do that, because I think when you see the whole picture, it's better to understand. That's the reason I brought the videos, you know, because you guys can see the rhythm that I could play and I could adapt to play only with one musician. I think it's good, but especially samba reggae, we need at least three or four musicians. You like understand the whole thing, you know. Now we have these three electrical, there are these big cars with sound system, like so powerful speakers, and the musicians play on top. Now they use like one person playing three surdos. And when we go on the street parading, each one has only one instrument. That's another thing that we do in Brazil as well. So yeah.
Awesome, man. Thank you, Everton. Yeah, thank you for sharing with us, man. It's really incredible. Yeah. Such incredible music.
Yeah, anytime, man. I'm looking forward to see you guys in play, you know, make music.
I know. This is all going on too long. We got to get together and make some music in person.
Yeah.
But yeah, I just wanted to say thank you on behalf of ALJA for sharing with us, and thank you to everyone who participated today.
Oh, thank you for participating as well. I'm so proud to be like one of the teaching artists in ALJA and like performing the orchestra as well so many times. So thank you so much. It's our pleasure to come and share my knowledge. And let's do it. Keeping this journey, learning every day, and try to make the world a better place with music.
That's all we can do, man.
Yeah.
That's all can do. Thank you. Yeah.